York City Vision Mobile Clinic gives out free eyeglasses to 15 students in Brooklyn. Cambodia has fertile land and abundant water, making it a great environment for agriculture. Welcome to Dot Headlines. I'm Maggie Tsai. Thank you for joining us. The City Vision Mobile Clinic carried out their first mission of the year at a secondary school in Brooklyn, New York, to help 15 students who needed eyeglasses. Most of them are immigrants, so they cannot afford to purchase their glasses. Let's take a look.
What is behind me is the Tsiji Vision Mobile Clinic. All the procedures are carried out in these two vehicles. And the best thing is that every student is able to bring his eyeglasses home today.
Grade 7 Angie is whom we will follow today. She and her family have just arrived in the U.S. in less than 1 year from Mexico. Her family is now rich, so they need help financially. This is also a common problem among the students in Brooklyn.
When they come to America, sometimes their paperwork doesn't allow them, through insurance or through green card or visa issues, that they don't get the proper care that they need, that a lot of our students do need glasses. Sometimes learning behaviors, or sometimes kids are over-emotional around a class. Sometimes it's just they can't read because they can't see.
After they complete registration, they'll go to the library first to undergo optometry and visual acuity examinations, together with an intraocular pressure test.
When we went to the glasses to check out my eyes, and with the air,
it's a little bit difficult, right?
Yeah.
We're now in the mobile clinic, and this is the last examination by the optometrist on a prescription Angie just received. Then Angie can have her glasses.
Okay,
O-R-T-H.
She is slightly nearsighted in both of her eyes, so for these diopters, she can wear glasses at school only. She doesn't need to wear them all day long.
And the last is the making of the glasses. The maker finds the correct spots for both eyes on the glasses and cut the lenses into the shape of the frame. In less than an hour, her eyeglasses are ready.
This is your daughter's prescription, okay?
I'm honored to receive the eyeglasses made by Tsiji. Both Angie and Carlos have one each. I'm very thankful.
Since last September, the Tsiji Vision Mobile Clinic has been carrying out its mission once every 2 weeks. They plan to go out 20 times this year to serve the underprivileged and immigrants in Brooklyn, hoping that a pair of eyeglasses can improve students' studies and their families' conditions.
A young nurse at the Tsiji Butterworth Dialysis Center in Malaysia treats dialysis patients with compassion. Her kind and gentle attitudes has won the trust of many patients, bringing positive energy to them. Let's see her story.
You see, buat macam ni, saya semacam from my heart, kita macam betul-betul kita syukur sangat kan. So saya macam every day saya akan cakap kan. Dia even saya bagi bread ataupun saya cucuk dekat pesakit. Mesti kan cakap, nanti kan apa cakap from your heart.
Norsai Mimi treats dialysis patients with kindness and courtesy. It all started many years ago, as she accompanied her mother to seek medical treatment.
The main reason for me to become a nurse is that once in the past, my mother was admitted to the hospital, yet a nurse was very unfriendly to her. At that time, I saw nurses should treat patients kindly.
Turning ideas into action, Norsai Mimi has been working in Tsiji Butterworth Dialysis Center for 4 years, and her initial aspiration is still the same.
She is quite gentle. Most of the dialysis patients are not afraid of meeting her and will tell her everything.
The heavy workload of being a nurse sometimes upsets her. Yet, the positive energy of Jinshi Aphorism and the encouragement from kidney patients are the driving force supporting her.
Thank you.
When the patients say they are grateful to me, I will also say I'm grateful in response. When I feel exalted, my kindness will disappear in an instant if I say I'm grateful to them.
Taking pride in being a white angel, she keeps treating patients with kindness, bringing sunshine and warmth to all of them.
According to an estimate from the Environmental Protection Administration, 2.75 million metric tons of food is wasted every year in Taiwan. So the government reminds the public to avoid buying excessive food, especially as the Lunar New Year is coming. If there is leftover food, an expert here teaches you how to maintain it in the fridge.
The supermarket is piled with all kinds of foods as the Lunar New Year is coming, so the consumers have to be careful in buying things. However, it is a difficult choice for everyone at this time of year.
The fruits are difficult to keep. We also have to buy a lot of things for the worship, and there are also certain things the kids don't eat, so we don't know how to prepare them.
I must make sure that everyone is well fed, but I often buy more than I need so that we can eat a few more days.
Every family will prepare radish, which symbolizes good luck. But if it is not finished, how should we preserve it?
Soak the tissue with water and place it upright in the fridge so it can remain fresh for 1 to 2 weeks. You can also do it this way. Steam it in a rice cooker and then put it in the freezer. It can be kept for 2 months. Potatoes will bud if they are not eaten, but you can put it with its natural enemy in the same bag.
The apples are climacteric fruits, so they will produce ethylene, which will stop the potatoes from budding.
Black spots easily appear on the skin of bananas, which will affect its texture. When you bring them home, you should separate them first.
When the ethylene vaporizes, the bananas will not rip together. If a small family like mine buys a bunch of bananas and they rip at the same time, it becomes tiring to finish them.
It is very common that people live in small families nowadays. Everyone is reminded to buy the right amount of food they need only, but not in excess, so that food will not be wasted.
During the Lunar New Year each year, about 10 to 20,000 people go to the emergency room because of the stomach flu. Some suffer due to overeating, while some suffer because they repeatedly heat the leftover dishes that can cause bacterial infections and cause stomach flu.
During the Lunar New Year, people always prepare a lot of delicious dishes, but oftentimes there are too many dishes to be eaten. The dishes are put into the fridge at the end of the day and are taken out to be microwaved the next day to be eaten. But if you heat dishes repeatedly, it can be bad for your health.
Many people can't sense the odd taste in food, but the food has already gone bad. After they eat it, they will suffer from diarrhea within 24 hours.
When you reheat food, it will destroy many valuable nutrients, and if you reheat it at a high temperature, the protein will produce heterocyclic amine, which is cancer-causing.
Can we kill the bacteria through heating food? Some bacteria can withstand high temperature. Even if you heat food at 100 degrees Celsius, you cannot completely wipe them out. We can handle it in a different way.
We can cook the food in a different way, such as cooking it in soup or turn leftovers into appetizers. We don't have to heat the food by microwaving.
Do not buy too much food for the Lunar New Year. When you cannot finish eating at meals, you should preserve it carefully and make sure it does not rot. You certainly do not want to spend your holiday at the emergency room.
The land which Cambodia, the country, sits on is over 180,000 square meters, much larger than Taiwan itself. But the population is only about two-thirds that of Taiwan. With its fertile land and plenty of water, it is a good environment to live in.
Flying 2,000 kilometers from Taiwan, we have arrived at the fertile land of Cambodia. Greenery as far as the eye can see. This is the land of rice and plenty. Cambodians have the habit of eating white rice or fried rice even in the morning. Even if it's a Western meal, rice is still pretty ingrained in their eating habits.
We must have rice each morning because then we'll have energy to work.
Local residents often think this way because Cambodia was a farming society to start, especially Battambang province, which takes 6 hours to reach from the capital of Phnom Penh. The province is not only the most populated in the northern region, but is further known as the rice granaries of Cambodia. This province's rice production alone is enough to feed the whole country. We are here at the Mar Khol district, which is a district within Battambang province. And this rice granary I'm standing at is the biggest rice producing company, where in just one day they can export 250 metric tons of rice. The factory stands on 14 hectares of land and purchases at least 700 tons of rice each day from local farmers, which then they process and sell. In order to speed up production, the factory has large machineries imported from Japan and Taiwan. This pile of dried rice is waiting for husking and polishing. Each equipment is linked together and is nearly automated. Rice, which is exported, is put through a strict standard. Rice grains, which are yellow or have black spots, do not pass inspection. The grains are polished 3 times to make the surface smooth for a better presentation. However, in recent years, rice harvesting has not been well, and it's especially affecting the local farmers, like this one who's drying his rice on the street side.
I have a plot of land about 2 hectares, and last year there was enough water supply, so I was able to harvest over 10 tons of rice. But this year, with my 2 hectares of land, I was only able to get 3 tons of rice.
Some of the farmers in Battambang began planting their seeds from April to July. But because of the drought, without rain, much of the rice have not grown. With not enough water, the rice seeds die, and they need to wait until September to start all over again.
With the weather problem causing the harvest to decrease, on top of which many young people aren't returning home to be a farmer. According to numbers, grain production in the economic values are rapidly decreasing each year. The average over 10 years ago was at a high of 21.1%, but the average in 2017 has dropped to a low 1.1%. Also due to economic development, there are less and less people going into farming, as the numbers drop from 80% to now 60%.
Many of the people don't go into farming anymore. They'll go to Phnom Penh or other provinces to work. Also, many apply to work in foreign countries.
Faced with this farming problem, the local government chose to solve the water issue first. This large water source next to the farm plots is put to use when the weather is hot and there is not enough rainwater to irrigate the farmland.
Now we have doubled the amount of harvest product since the government has solved the water supply problem by diverting lake and river waters into the water canal. Now the rice is so abundant that the farmers are unable to sell their rice at the market, which is now another problem.
With an abundant supply of rice, the country has just realized the competitiveness of the global market. The nearby country of Thailand, although it does not have the natural fertile land of Cambodia, it does have the advantage of technology to help and is able to produce just as high of a quality of rice and produces nearly double the amount. Thus, for Cambodia, how to follow this growth trend and promote a win-win situation for both agriculture and the economy is their next big challenge.
Now we continue to look back at Tsuji's major events that took place in both September and October of 2019.
In September, Tsuji held concerts to observe the 20th anniversary of the 921 earthquake. On On September 21, 1999, a major earthquake struck Taiwan. In the immediate aftermath, Tsuji volunteers from across the island rushed to the disaster areas to carry out relief, providing food, water, and many other supplies. Free clinics were also held for disaster survivors. After the earthquake, Tsuji also helped to rebuild 51 schools. In September, Tsuji's Mission of Education celebrated its 30th anniversary. A Tsuji University alumnus also came to express his gratitude.
从国中、高中到大学医学系毕业，我很感谢慈济这12年里面教会了我一件最重要的事。In
2019, Tsuji University was ranked 67th worldwide, 10th in Asia, and top in Taiwan in Global University Impact Ranking. Dr. Yang Su-biao is the first principal of the first school Tsuji founded in 1989. At 100 years old, Dr. Yang still dedicates himself to medical education. In October, Tsuji volunteers in Malaysia took to the streets to inspire goodness in people by encouraging everyone to give and pray for world peace.
Tsuji effort to organize this once a year to practice a caring, sharing attitude.
Treating everyone equal as humans. Bravo, Tsuji, for your great effort.
Tsuji volunteers in Malaysia not only care for the locals, but also refugees. Apart from charity work, they also carry out Tsuji's missions of medicine and education across Malaysia. In October, construction of the Tsuji International School in Kuala Lumpur was completed, which will provide education from preschool to pre-college program. In Thailand, Tsuji provides free medical services to refugees every month. At the site of the free clinic, vocational training is also available. In Turkey, Tsuji has been giving out cash cards to Syrian refugees monthly since 2014. Inspired by Tsuji's love, many gave back by serving as a volunteer. In October 2019, 18 of them were recognized for 5 years of volunteer service. In 2017, the new school building Tsuji rented for Syrian children in Istanbul opened.
كما نرى اليوم طلاب ومعلمو مدرسة المناهل فرع إسطنبول لقد أتوا اليوم لمساعدة إخوانهم في الدول الثلاثة الإفريقية المتضررة من أثر الإعصار.
With what they've been through, these children are even more able to feel for the suffering of others. In October, the president of Indonesia visited a housing community Tsuji built for quake survivors.
Swasta semuanya bisa bergerak bersama-sama dalam membantu apabila terjadi bencana. Ini sebuah kerjasama yang baik.
Tanggapan Bapak Presiden sangat puas sekali bahwa untuk bangunannya ini.
Back in 2018, Indonesia was hit by two major earthquakes in one day. In 2019, Tsuji broke ground for the construction of permanent houses for the quake survivors. 6 months later, Tsuji and the Indonesian military renewed their memorandum to help disaster survivors.
Sangat profesional karena Bapak Tsuji mampu untuk memberikan yang terbaik untuk masyarakat. Salah satu contoh adalah.
In October, the Tsuji Center in New York opened.
因缘不可思议，今天我们都共襄盛举。
It is overall a very uplifting, sacred story of how the organization was founded and has continued to grow around the world.
In 2019, Tsuji USA turned 30 years old.
The whole purpose of Buddhism, as I understand it, is to alleviate suffering.
El amor es algo.
Tsuji USA's areas of support cover the entire Americas. Take Mexico, for example. After two major earthquakes devastated Mexico in 2017, Tsuji has been going back regularly to hold free clinics for quake survivors.
Tomo pastillas y pastillas toda la vida, estoy con el dolor y el dolor, el dolor, el dolor. No, ahorita ya me siento pues mucho adelante. Ahorita me voy a ir al baile.
I will come, definitely.
Apart from holding free clinics, Tsuji is now rebuilding a Catholic school damaged by the quakes.
Muy buenos días, tengan todos los presentes. El Instituto Morelos les da la más cordial bienvenida a esta su casa. En nuestro corazón solo hay sentimientos de agradecimiento para con ustedes.
It's a lot of people around the whole world that put their love together. Tsuji, which means compassion and relief in Mandarin Chinese.
In Haiti, Tsuji USA is still providing support to the people affected by a major earthquake in 2010.
C'est lui-même qui permet nous capables à recevoir du vie aujourd'hui.
Il faut remercier Master Chen Yang à cause de sa compassion et de son amour pour les déshérités, pour les plus pauvres.
Aidez-nous en ville, aidez-nous vivre, aidez-nous comprendre, aidez-nous vivre à mon. Mais comme ça, il va venir seul pour nous dire, il va venir aider nous tout vivre de l'autre façon.
Beto Junior High School hosted the first Makers Camp for students to stimulate their creativity with science education. Take a look and Happy New Year!